Hi guys, how are you? Guys, today's video is about how to make money online, yet another addition to my previous video on making money online, which I saw helped a lot of people, and I got a lot of comments where people told me that they could enroll themselves on that website which I was talking about and they started making money. Trust me, there is no bigger feeling than this when you feel that you really helped somebody in growing in their lives. So anyway, I'm back with this video where I'm going to be telling you what happened in the last 1 year. Let us start with the mindset part. So it happened because I had set my mind that I would start making money online. I went to naukri.com. I changed all my details over there. Earlier, I had put my request for finance and accountancy, but since I wanted to stop doing a normal corporate job, so I changed my details and I put them to teaching. And I included stuff like online teaching and accountancy, math teacher, all those keywords to my naukri.com account. I got an email from Merit Nation and they told me that they are looking for math teachers. I quickly called them up and that is how it all started. So these classes by Merit Nation, they happen online for students and students can register themselves on their website. And that is how the classes happen. This video will tell you exactly how to become a teacher for these classes. I got myself an interview scheduled, and after the interview was scheduled, I went to Govindpuri for the interview, and I screwed it up. Yes, I screwed up my interview. I was very confident about mathematics because I was always very strong in that subject, so I really did not go with a lot of preparation, and they totally got me. They asked me such puzzling questions that I was trying to be more smiley and friendly, but it didn't work. Anyway, I was not selected for the interview. There were two people who took my interview, and after that interview, I had this feeling that I'm not going to be selected for this one. So while I was getting out of the office, I went up to the guy who had contacted me for the interview and the HR basically. I went up to him and I told him I want to get an interview done for accountancy. And see, I told you in my last video also that when you are a CA, you do have certain advantages. So this is one definite advantage that I experience. If people know that I'm a CA, they trust me with my accountancy and taxation. So these guys also trusted me. Then I went back for accountancy interview, and this time it went very well because I had studied a lot for this interview. I had studied days and nights. I had bought two new books for 11th and 12th. And I finished those two books before my interview. No, I did not write anything, okay? I was just looking at the solutions, and that is how I prepared for the interview. I went there for my interview, and this time I really did not want to mess things up the way I had messed up the last time. So that is how it happened. It went very well, and I was confident this time that I must have cleared. They did not give me the feedback right then. They asked me to come back after a while if they give me a call. So I was waiting for the call, and I think I must have bothered them then also, because that's how I am. If I am waiting for something, I call up the HRs too many times, and that is what I did that day also, and that is what I did to them also. I roughly called them up for like 4 to 5 times before they actually told me that they've selected me. Anyway, I don't know, I end up being too desperate, I guess. But anyway, so that is how I got my interview done and got selected. After that, what happened was they called me for a demo class. Now this was a very scary feeling because I had no experience of talking online with people. No. So anyway, I definitely have this good habit of showing up courage when it is most needed. So I went there for my demo class. I was in front of a computer and there was a camera on the computer. And that is how the class happened. They asked me to choose a topic of my own choice. I picked up some debentures or something from accountancy, and I taught. And there were few people on the other side. I do not know still who they were, but there were 5 to 6 people. And that time I had to actually pretend like an online teacher. While the class was going on, they were asking me questions on live chat, which I was answering to. And after the class was over, I bothered them again and I wanted the answer right then. I was after the life of HR. Please tell me whether I'm selected or not. And he was like, ma'am, we really cannot help it. You will have to wait till Monday. And that was Friday that day. And 2 days I was waiting desperately. I still remember. Anyway, so Monday or Tuesday, I got a call from them and they told me that they selected me. And I was very happy. It was one day before my birthday. I was very happy. Perhaps I was desperately waiting for this call and it really made my birthday. So anyway, there were other reasons also to make my birthday happy. But anyway, then I got a call and they told me that they have finalized me for accountancy as an online teacher. I was very happy. No matter what they were paying me, I was happy because I could do it. And secondly, it was like a window that opened to me, a new door to towards making money online, which I know has a lot of potential. So I always wanted to do something with the comfort of my home. I wanted to do something in my life which I can do sitting anywhere in the world. I don't want to be bound to some geographic boundaries. So this is why I was very happy, because this is one thing that you can do from anywhere in the world. Anyway, while I'm traveling, you know what, I have taken classes while traveling also. So I carry my stuff and wherever I go, if I have a class, and I take my class from wherever I am, and it just goes fine. And apart from that, the remuneration is 600 rupees per hour. That's what I know about my subject. But you know what, the money is not really something that you can be aspiring for when you are beginning something new. Something else is motivating. Something else is the motivation factor. For me, the biggest motivation factor was the new way that I would explore for making money. Because if you are ambitious, you really want to do something in life, there are many, many ways you can make money. And this is one of the very good ways where you earn respect along with making some good money. And you get the backing of a good reputed platform for you. Like Merit Nation is a reputed company, and I definitely wanted to be a part of it. Now let me tell you how exactly the classes happen. The classes happen with this banner at the back, okay? And during the class, your video, your live video is appearing on the top right corner of the laptop or the screens of the students, and even on your own screen. Then you have a huge space where you write, okay? And you write on it using this and your stylus, okay? So whatever you write on this pad appears on the screen of the students and also on your own screen. And you have a live chat window right beneath your live video box, okay? So students keep asking different questions, and you have to answer to them while taking the class. So it's a very interactive process. It's not dull, and it does not let you sleep. The students also enjoy, and the teacher is definitely enjoying taking the class. I definitely enjoy a lot because I love to teach. It's like a passion to me. And apart from that, what else would I want to talk about? No. There is nothing else I want to talk about now. I am mostly done with everything. Just one thing is left. If you want to be a teacher with Meritnation, please contact them and they will definitely schedule something for you if they would find your profile interesting enough. And you have to be good with your communication skills, you have to be good with your English. Now let me talk about a few good things that I found about Meritnation. Firstly, I see an element of care in their behavior. So they are very, very caring for their students, and they make sure that the video delivery, the content should be amazing. The slides are already there in place. When you teach with the help of slides, okay? And there are roughly 30 to 40 slides in one class, which you can switch up during the class, okay? You keep switching and you keep talking about the new slide. You have a portal given to you by Meritnation which shows your classes, and the slides are already uploaded on every class. So before actually the class happens, you can go and visit the portal and you can see the slideshow and you can prepare for the slide. And you are rated for every class that you take. That is also very interesting. I remember I used to eagerly wait for my rating, and I used to hope that my rating increases every time I take a class. And apart from that, yeah, but by the way, my rating is very good. I am, what am I, 4.7 is my rating out of 5, which is a good rating according to me. I think so. Okay. Then you get rated by students, and you have to be careful with your presentation. You have to look good during the class. So although there is no condition of wearing any formals or anything, you can wear anything for the class, but you have to be presentable, of course. Then the banner has to be prim and perfect. If the banner is crooked, they will definitely give you a feedback. So your classes are rated by the students and they are reviewed by the internal staff. And another very, very interesting thing about Meritnation is that while the class is going on, they have their IT team online and you are connected to them on your Gmail chat. Okay, so if anything goes wrong during the class, you have to quickly let them know, and these guys are so careful about this thing. The moment you will write something to them, in a second they will reply you. So sometimes if there is a problem with the audio or video, you can let them know and they'll resolve it right then and there. Classes are of 1 hour, they can be for more than 1 hour also, like they can be for 2 hours. But in case of 2 hours, you can definitely take a break, and you have to tell the IT team to stop the recording for that duration. And then you can take a break, you can announce the break, and students will also go offline, and you can also go offline for a while, and then you can come back like 5, 7 minutes, 10 minutes. And let me tell you one fun thing before I end the video. Generally, these students, they become very good friends with you and they start to know you, and you'd start to know them by their names, although they are too many in number. Students get to see you, but you don't get to see the students. They are only on chat. And it's very frequent that they post you friend request on Facebook, so that is also common, but you're not supposed to accept those requests from students. That's it. I think I have covered everything. If there is anything you would want to ask me, or you would want me to explain better, you have to contact me. I will definitely answer to your query. And please let me know if there is anything more that you would want me to post a video on. I would love to do it. So that's it from my end, guys. Have lots and lots of fun and lots of money. Bye.